know if I have another copy of the thing showing. Mine.
Right. So the portfolio is the evil you know. The final is unknown. All right, so here we go. You'll notice that these problems on the review guide are very similar to the ones that I gave out on Friday. We didn't do all the Friday's homework together because the last half of that homework was all the same problems, just with the numbers changed, if you didn't notice. So that's on you to do tomorrow. We've already done the examples earlier on in the homework that match up with those. And if you didn't get those because you weren't there, or if you want more examples, good news. Now they're on here. Okay?
So, Troy, you weren't here. Do I have another copy of that?
You should. Question where?
Yes, I do. Right here.
Does anybody else need another copy of the homework on Friday?
Yes.
Very soon.
Yes.
Although it wasn't homework because technically it wasn't due today. It's due Tuesday.
Right. You want me to show you what it is?
Wait, yeah.
Stuff we did in class.
We did the first like page together, and the second page is basically just the same problems with the numbers.
Cool. And if they aren't, because you were gone or don't remember, they're very similar to what we're doing here. All right, number one. It says, find the value of two numbers if their sum is 2 and their difference is negative 7. So first of all, what are our unknowns? We don't know the two numbers, right? So let's call them X and Y. Assume they're two different numbers. So X and Y are the two numbers. Their sum is 2. So how do I write that as a relationship between X and Y? Go ahead. Say it again. Plus 2, nope, sum is 2, that means they sum to 2. Does that make sense? So they equal 2. Adding or subtracting? Adding, yeah. So x plus y is going to be 2. Two numbers, their sum is 2, right? They add the 2. Cool. Their difference is negative 7. So if I subtract them, x minus y, I should get negative 7. Okay. Now, the x here and the y here are the same x and y's, right? So they're in a system. We can solve them. Two variables, two equations, we can do this. How do you want to do it? The setup seems to imply standard form, which is probably easiest to solve with elimination, right? Do you guys want to rock that elimination? All right, so we need to multiply or multiply the top or the bottom to make a match, but in this case, they already do, right? See how x and x already match? So do I do x minus x to get rid of it or x plus x? Correct. So I'm going to subtract everything. Don't forget to look back at the minus. So we have x minus x. Is that 0x? Good. Make sure it is. Some of you guys are adding these and saying it equals 0x, and that's just not true. Make sure it actually does. X minus x is, in fact, 0x, so it goes away, which is what we wanted. Y minus negative y. So that's y plus y, 2y. Don't lose your equal signs. 2 minus negative 7. Again, keep looking back. We're subtracting, right? 2 minus negative 7 is 2 plus 7, which is 9. So y is going to be 9 halves. Any complaints? If I plug in 9 halves for y, let's plug into the top equation. We get x plus 9 halves equals 2. We subtract 9 halves, we get this. We need common denominators. How many halves are in the number 2? 4 halves. Another way to think of that is think of this as 2 over 1. The 1, we multiply by 2 to get a 2, so we multiply the top by 2 as well. So x must have been negative 5 halves. Objections? Is negative 5 halves minus 9 halves negative 7? Well, think about it. Negative 5 halves. Minus 9 more halves. How many halves is that? Negative 14 halves. Is negative 14 halves the same thing as negative 7? Yes. Check it in the top. Negative 5 halves plus 9 halves. Is that 2? Negative 5 halves plus 9 halves. How many halves do I have left over? 4 halves. Is 4 halves 2? Then it checks out. Jordan, you with me? Okay. Just want to make sure. How are we doing, everybody, over there? For real? Okay. Number 2, the difference of two numbers is 6. So x and y, their difference is 6. Their sum is 16. Same setup as the last one. How do you want to solve it? Elimination? Now, if you did elimination, x and x already go away. So what would we want to do? Subtract or add? We'd want to subtract. If we did that, we'd get negative y minus y, which is negative 2y. 6 minus 16 is negative 10. We divide and get x equals 5. Now, I read that a lot loud instead of doing it because I'm actually going to do substitution for this one. Not because it's more efficient, but because it's another way that you might like. Nevaeh likes substitution. So, if we're going to do substitution, which variable do you want to get on its own and which equation do you want to work with? Bottom one. All right, we're going to work with the bottom one. We're going to color code that green. Which variable do you want to get on its own? Okay, so what do we do to get the x gone? Okay, so I'm going to rewrite this as y equals negative x plus 16. I'll pause for station identification. Does everybody see how I got from this to that? Subtracting x. I just wrote the negative x first. Positive 16 was already there. Now I'm going to take that I know is y, and I'm going to plug it in. I'm going to plug it in right here. X plus negative x plus 16 equals 16. When I do this, I get x minus x, which is 0, and I get 16 equals 16. True or false? True. So infinitely many solutions, right? Where did I mess up? We plugged it back into itself. So of course we're going to get infinitely many solutions.
If we had the same equation for both, right? We did this thing. Don't plug it back into itself.
Oh my God, because then I can make the mistake for you guys instead of you having to make it tomorrow to learn from it, right? It's like we did a practice test and you goofed. So now you know that's an issue, so watch out for that. We're going to plug that into the top. When we plug that into the top, we know that we get x minus whatever y is. Wrap it in parentheses when you plug something in. If you don't, you're going to forget to distribute that negative. That's right, negative x plus 16. Do we see why we need to wrap that in parentheses? Because that negative is going to distribute. And what we're going to get is x plus x minus 16. Don't forget to distribute that negative a second time, right? Equals 6. So we get 2x equals 32. Sorry, not 32. Didn't do that one on purpose. 22. And x equals 11. Interesting. Well, if x is 11, what's y going to be? 5. Now, does 11 and 5 work for both equations? If we plug it in the bottom, x is 11, y is 5, that's 16, correct? If x is 11 and we subtract 5, do we get 6? Yep, then it works for both. That must be the solution they share. 11 and 5 are the numbers I was thinking of. So the danger of substitution, plugging it back into the same equation, also forgetting to wrap it in parentheses when you plug it in, right? Sometimes you'll be fine, sometimes you won't be. Number 3. On the first day of ticket sales, my true love gave to me. The school sold 35 student tickets and 40 adult tickets for a total of $270. Okay. The school took in $366 the next day by selling 43 student tickets and 56 adult tickets. How much was the cost of each type of ticket? So what is the thing we don't know? How much each ticket costs? So what kind of tickets do we have? It says type of ticket. We have student, which I'm going to call kid, because S's look like fives. And we have adults. So we have K and A. And K and A stand for the number of tickets for kids and adults, or the cost? The cost. Right? So would it be true that if I sold 35 kid tickets, 35 times K is going to tell me how much money I made from the kids' tickets? Right? And if I add that to 40 times A, I'll get the total number of profit for the first day. Are you smelling what I'm stepping in? 35 student tickets times the amount that they cost, plus 40 adult tickets times the amount that the adults' tickets cost, will get us $270. You smell what I'm stepping in? Jordan? Okay. Day two, the total was 366. They sold 43 kids' tickets and 56 adult tickets. This is our system. The setup is the hard part. The rest is what we're doing next week. My face came what? Oh, I see what you're saying. How do you want to solve this? Elimination wouldn't be bad. You know what I see? These are really big numbers. Is there a way I could make these all smaller numbers before I begin? Let's look at the top equation. What are all three coefficients divisible by?
Five.
So let's divide them all by five. As long as we do it to everything, we're good. So 35 divided by 5 is 7. 40 divided by 5 is 8. 270 divided by 5. Well, 200 divided by 5 is 40. 70 divided by 5. What's that? 14. So 14 and 40 makes 54. Okay. Now, why did I do that? Not to make things go away, but to make the numbers smaller so I'm not multiplying big numbers, right? So now, what can I multiply the green equation by to make it match up on the bottom? 3 wouldn't get me any of these. 7. What's going to happen when I multiply the top by 7? The 8 is going to match up with 56, because 8 times 7 is 56. So I'm going to rewrite this equation, and I'm going to write it like this. Times 7 is 49K plus 56A, 54 times 7. What's 50 times 7? 350. What's 4 times 7? So it's 350 plus 28, which is 378. So these are the equations I'm looking at, just so we're clear. Does everyone see how I made that a little bit easier to do? I reduced the first equation as much as I could, right? Rest in peace. Good night, sweet prince. All right. Now, are we going to subtract or add these to make them go away? Subtract in this case. What's 43 minus 49? Negative 6K. Good job not forgetting your sign. What's 56 minus 56? Good. Check to make sure it does actually equal 0. Don't forget your equal sign. 366 minus 378. Then we divide by negative 6, and K is 2. So they sold 2 kids tickets, right? What? $2 per ticket. Nice job. This kid's on fire. From downtown, the Iceman. All right, K equals 2. You never play NBA Jam? You don't know the announcer from that? From downtown, he's on fire, the Iceman, right? Come on, we need that in here. I need like a buzzer that I can press when you guys like work on that for me. K equals 2. I need a soundboard. Like they have in radio shows, right? You know what I'm talking about, where they play the different sounds? Thank you. Shut up. All right, K equals 2. That means $2 per ticket, right, for kids. Awesome. Let's figure out how much it costs for adults. How are we going to do that? How are we going to do it? Jace. Okay, so which one do you want to plug it into? How about this one? Right? As long as you didn't screw it up from here to here, that's still valid, right? So let's plug in K for 2, and we get 7 times 2 plus 8A equals 54. So that's 14 plus 8A equals 54. We subtract 14, we get 40. We divide by 8, we get 5. Adult tickets for $5. No. I don't want you to write this down necessarily. I want you to understand what's going on. So if I'm going too fast because you can't write, then stop writing. If you really want a copy of this, I can copy for you in the copy room right after class and hand it to you. Right? Or you can watch the video, or I don't know, or take a picture. What?
Word problems are stupid.
It's just a setup. What's good about word problems is it makes you think about what stuff means, right? When I say K is 2 and A is 5, great, fantastic. But when you think about what K is the cost of each ticket, right? And seeing how we can apply it, that's useful. Also, when you get to geometry, there's going to be a lot of stuff that you're going to have to be like, what do these numbers actually stand for? When I say X squared, I literally mean X put on a square. It's going to blow your freaking mind.
Wait a minute. That's why I have next year. I'm not waiting on next year.
Well, you should be. Because algebra hard, geometry easy, and if you're good at algebra, geometry will be a breeze. The thing that kicks geometry kids' butt is algebra. The thing that kicks calculus kids' butt is the algebra. Calculus easy, algebra hard. It is. Algebra is the hard part of everything. Okay. A boat traveled 100 miles downstream and back. Round trip.
That's 200 miles.
By the time the problems make it to the quiz, you've already seen it on the homework, and you've already seen it on the review guide, right? It's the same thing! Has been all year. That's the secret. Please, don't tell anyone.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's different?
The trip downstream took 3 hours. The trip upstream took 5, right? Because when you go up a stream, it takes longer because the current's working against you. What was the speed of the boat heading upstream and the speed of the boat heading downstream? Well, it took 100 miles downstream and back, which means when we went downstream, we traveled 50 miles. And when we went upstream, we traveled 50 miles, right?
Okay.
Trip downstream took 3 hours. Okay. So after going downstream 3 hours, that's the boat speed, let's go B, times 3, we traveled 50 miles. And then also when we traveled 5 hours, using the boat speed, we traveled 50 miles. That's it. Right? How do we know this can't be right? A number times 3 is 50. A number times 5 is 50. Yeah. You can't be both, right? It's either B is 10, and then it's not up here, or B is some fraction, 50 over 3, or it's, you know, it's not down here. So why is this is wrong? What's the correct setup? Doesn't B stand for the overall boat speed, though? Like, the actual speed it's going?
I said C. So you did B minus. Logan, don't break it.
Yeah, we get 1. And if you break it, everyone will hate you, because I don't accept papers unless they're stapled, and I won't be buying a stapler for everyone, which means you'll have to bring in your own staples. I'll make him hate you. I can break him. Is the boat speed the same upstream and downstream? Exactly. So B and B aren't going to be the same. So we have upstream speed and we have downstream speed. Okay, so that makes a little bit more sense. Downstream is faster. Downstream is faster.
3D?
This is all true. Another way to write this would be to say 3 hours times our downstream speed plus 5 hours times our upstream speed equals 100. So there's one equation. That's because you're smart. But we need another equation. We have one equation with 2 variables. Where's the other equation going to come from? What? 5D minus, wait, what?
5U minus 3D.
Minus 3D equals what?
100 minus that.
Well, that's just rearranging the same equation. We need a wholly different equation.
Elimination.
Can't do that until we have 2 equations. We need 2 variables, 2 equations.
Make another equation.
Yeah. D plus U equals what? Now you're just guessing.
No, that doesn't
is, ooh, I got it.
Yeah.
B is 100 over 3, and U is 20.
Yeah.
I didn't think about that one.
It's a system of equation worksheet. Shouldn't it have to be a system of equations?
Yes.
Who has the homework from yesterday, or from Friday? How do we solve a problem like Maria?
I don't know.
You did a good job. No matter what, I want you to know you did a good job, okay? Things are going to get weird. You did a good job. We'll come back to that one. Number 5, the senior class at Super Big High School rented 4 vans and 3 buses for a trip to Washington, D.C. Woo! Our nation's beloved capital. The junior class rented 3 vans and 4 buses. The junior class is 110 more students than the senior class, and the senior class contains 265. How many students in each van and each bus? Well, the junior class has a total of 110 students, right? 110 more than the senior class, so how much does the junior class have?
375.
Everybody see where I got 375?
No.
Senior class contains 265. Junior class has 110 more. So, 375. They could have just told us that, but they were jerks. Now, the junior class, what did they do for rentals? 3 vans. 3 times the capacity of the van. Plus 4 times the capacity of the bus is going to give us the total number of students, right? 4 buses with however many fits in a bus, 3 vans with however many fits in a van will be 375 in total. Assuming we're packing to capacity, no leftover seats. Now, the senior class is how big?
265.
That's what I weigh. Jacked. All right. What did the senior class rent? You may not like it, but this is what peak performance looks like. What did the senior class rent? 4 vans and 3 buses. There's a system of equations. How you feel? 3 times the amount the van can fit plus 4 times the amount the bus can fit will be the total number of students. Because we have 4 buses and 3 vans to work with. They had 4 vans and 3 buses to work with, and they fit 265 exactly. How do you want to solve it? Substitution, subtraction, elimination, what?
Elimination.
Elimination. What do you want to multiply by?
B.
What do you want to multiply by to make a match up?
3 and 4.
Let's multiply the top by 4, and that becomes 12V plus 16B equals, oh God, what's 375 times 4? What's 75 times 4? 300. What's 300 times 4?
1,200.
What's 1,200 plus 300?
1,300.
Yep. We're going to multiply this by 4 or 3? 3 to make a match up. So 12V plus 9B, 265 times 3. 200 times 3 is 600. 60 times 3 is 180. So we have 780. What's 5 times 3?
5 times 3 is
15. 15. So 780 plus 15?
795.
795. That looks right. About 250. We're times it by 3. It's going to be about 7,500 or 750, right? A little bit more. Now, are we adding or subtracting to make these go away?
Subtracting,
don't forget to look back at it. 12 minus 12 goes away, correct?
Yes.
Good, then we chose the right sign. 16 minus 9 is?
7.
7B. 1,500 minus 795. What's 1,500 minus 800? 700. We overshot by 5, so 705. Right? 700 plus 700 is 1,400. 95 plus 5 is? 100. 1,500. Now we divide by 7. Oh, God. That's not going to work out correctly. Did we screw up? And if so, where did we? Did we screw up?
No.
Let me think.
There's just
I will.
So we multiply the top equation by 3?
No. Multiply the top by 4.
By 4 and the bottom by 3.
The bottom by 3 to get them to match, yeah. Does that check out? Did we do our math right? That's right. So when we divide by 7, we're going to get a leftover, aren't we? It's going to go into 100 times and 5 sevenths. So if you wanted to use a mixed number, 105 sevenths. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to leave it at 705 over 7 because that's going to be easier to work with. Let's plug that back in. You're going to plug it into the top or the bottom equation?
Bottom
equation. So we have 4v plus 3 times whatever b was equals 265. So we have 3 times 705 over 7. Gross. What's 3 times 705?
2115.
Ugh, disgusting. Now, you can subtract that over here and then get common denominators. It's up to you. That's what makes this one hard. Okay. We can subtract that and get common denominators, or you want to get rid of that division? Why not multiply everything by 7? We can, right?
Yes.
Just gonna make the numbers big, but at least they're not fractions. We get 28v, 2115. What's 265 times 7? You gotta know that, right? 5 times 7 is 35. 60 times 7 is 420. 420 plus 35 is 455. What's 200 times 7?
1400.
1,400, so we have 1,400 plus 455 is 1,855.
Wow.
Subtract 2,115. We're going to get a negative number. Did we goof?
You can't have negative students.
Oh, man. So we subtract. We get 1,855 minus 2,115. I'm going to count up to that. So that's 5 to get to 60, 45 to get to 1,900. 145 to get to 2,000. 245 to get to 2,100. 255 to get to 2,110. And 2,160 to get to there.
What?
Oh, shoot, I just lost track. Yep, I added on a digit somewhere. Crap. 5 to get to there, 45 to get to there, 145, 245. Nope, 145 to get to 2,000. 45 plus this is 260.
Mm-hmm.
Negative. V is going to equal what? Reduce. Divide by 2.
It's not 10.
14 is divisible by 7 and 2. Is 130 divisible by 7?
No.
How do you know? Man's on fire. So that's it. There's our answer. Will it be that bad on the quiz tomorrow? No.
You can't have negative students, though.
Yeah, you can't. Yeah.
We lost some students on the way.
Well, think about it. B, shouldn't we have expected a negative number? B is over 100 in 5/7. So a bus fits 105/7 students. If we plug that in, 105/7 times 3 is already bigger than 265. So we better have negative students on this van. Somebody done goofed.
Ew.
It was this guy. I made it this morning. Sorry, guys. Oops. Crap happens. Number 4. How do you solve a problem, Maria?
Ooh, I got this.
Yeah?
I know.
Okay. Parker, you had the homework from yesterday?
Aww.
On Friday? Who had it? Yeah, how do we solve it? How do we set it up?
But I'll do those. It doesn't make sense. Oh, shit.
Can you read me what you have? Three B plus C equals 15? 50. And that's from yesterday, right?
No.
That's from today? What?
Okay, remember what's on here?
Yes.
Oh.
So give me the problem from the other day, which I have here.
What number is the problem that I'm talking about?
Help me out. Crap, this is one side.
Nope.
We're talking number 8. No, we're not. We're talking about...
It was on the first page, wasn't it? Number 6.
Number 6. How did we do it yesterday? Or on Friday?
What?
Oh, no, that's a really long time ago. 10 plus 1 plus 5.
Explain. This is why we do word problems. Parker, what does this mean? Yep, that's fine. Jace, sorry. I'll give you a second, but I got to go on to somebody else. Yeah. This stands for hours? Close, but not quite. Go. Cool, so B is the boat speed, C is the current speed. When they're going together, they add, right?
Yes.
Took 10 hours. So 10 hours of boat speed plus the current equals 105. Now that should be in parentheses because it applies to both, right? 10 hours of current adding on to it, 10 hours of boat speed adding on to it. Same thing here. We have boat speed minus the current, right? Whatever we're doing, times 70. Now, the difference between what we did earlier and what this was is interpretation, right? When we said boat speed, on the last one, we thought, oh, the overall speed, which is this combined already. We called that one idea. But that's not what they're asking. They're asking, how fast was the boat trying to go before we applied the current? So we have the boat, how much it's trying to do, plus the current that's adding onto it, times 10. We have the boat minus the current, which is what it's actually doing, times 70. So go back to this problem. Let's do it. So we have how much the boat is trying to go plus the current, and how much the boat is trying to go minus the current. How long did we spend with the current going together with the boat? 3 hours downstream. And that should equal 50 miles, right? We're going against the current for how long?
5 hours.
Here we are. You still did a good job. How do you solve the problem, Maria? Why are we distributing? If we distribute the 3 and the 5, then we get standard form, right?
Yeah.
Which means we can then do elimination. That's fine. Or you could take the bottom one, divide by 5, and get either B or C on its own and do substitution, right? So you want to distribute and then do elimination, or do you want to divide by 5 in the bottom and then do substitution? Elimination or substitution, which one are you going to do?
Elimination.
Elimination, we should distribute. So what we do is we get 3B plus 3C equals 50. 5B minus 5C equals 50. Elimination, we got to get them to match up. What do we multiply the top and the bottom by to make them go away?
Top by 5, bottom by
3. So we're going to get 15B plus 15C equals 250. And the bottom, we're going to get 15B minus 15C equals 150. Add or subtract to make them go away. Subtract 15B minus 15B does go away, correct?
Yes.
What's 15C minus negative 15C?
30C.
250 minus 150? Hundo. C equals 100 over 30, which is 10 over 3. Ew. How do we find B?
Plug it back in.
Yeah. Ordering a pizza?
Huh?
Ordering a pizza from Casey's?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I would do. I tried ordering using the app, but it doesn't work at Morrison anymore. So you have to call in. Make sure you order it for like later, because they'll have it done in 15 minutes and it'll get cold. So make sure you order like with a pickup time.
I'm listening to music.
Good idea. All right, so 10 over 3 is C. So I'm going to plug that back in and solve. Let's plug it into the top one. 3 times whatever B plus whatever C is, which we said was 10 over 3, equals 50. I distribute the 3, I get 3B plus 10 equals 50. So the speed of the current was 10 over 3, which is 3 and a third, right? 3 and a third mile. B is the speed of the boat. It's 13 and a third. I accept it as improper. Good news is tomorrow you won't have that type of stuff, but you could.
But
you won't. But I also said trust no one. You gonna be in the hospital tomorrow?
Yeah, I'm going tonight.
That's exciting.
I gotta get blood drawn, but I only drink all day, so I'm gonna put an IV. Last time I had an IV, I passed out. If I pass out, I have to stay the night.
Stay hydrated.
Stay hydrated. Don't stay the night, stay hydrated. How do we feel about these?
I don't like them, but I...
Boat problem and bus problem, not very fun, right?
No.
But the rest were okay? Do we see how to do the boat problem? It's a very easy way to get confused. You can have the thing. It's very easy to get confused about what they're asking about. Remember, the boat's overall speed is the boat speed plus the current, or the boat speed minus the current. That's where your two variables are. You what? Okay. Yes, you may. That's what you're asking. Yeah. What? Sure, everybody can come into our homeroom. Who needs a pass? You will get in trouble if you don't sign in there for attendance. You what? You have extras?
Yeah, that's extras.
Awesome, thanks. If you don't have a pass and you don't go up there to sign in, you will be marked absent and you'll get in trouble. Don't let that happen to you.
Can I go use the pier?
No.
Can I go up there right now and give it to them?
No, because they're busy teaching. Stay here. You guys are in the same? Okay.
Can I get one?
Are you guys in the same room?
I'm in Mackie Quackie.
You guys are in the same? Okay. You can, yeah.
How many of pass
to them? How about my shoulder?
Can I go pee?
Yes, just not in here. What do you need?
Pass.
Okay. Isaiah, what room are you in?
Stevenson.
Stevenson, okay.
I got two.
I need one. And this is only okay if they let you out, because I know that like freshman academy stuff is weird. I don't know. I don't know about that stuff. If you do end up having it for whatever God knows reason, you listen to them, not me. Yeah.
No wonder why.
Save the back seats for you? No, if you're learning, you need to be in the front so I can talk to you.
There you go. You're trying to kill it.
I was not.
Yes.
She's trying to put the hands
in
the ball.
That was Jack. Jack was shaking it upside down.
I was holding the ball trying to catch it so it wouldn't die.
Bro, she has a glove that you can just pick the hamster up with.
Really?
Really?
Yeah, I stole her gloves, but the gloves didn't stop biting.
Everybody else needs passes? All right. Tucker. What do you need, Nevaeh?
I need help, because I did it the other way.
Wonderful. What do you need? Can I repeat my question? During homeroom? Have you talked to me about it yet and worked with me on it? Okay, come on in and we'll work on it. You need a pass? Yes, okay. What room are you in? Is he going to be okay with you coming down here? You sure?
What'd you do?
100%. 100%.
Thank you.
Oh, you're not Freshman Academy with him, are you?
I'm not a freshman.
You're not a freshman, that's right.
Got it.
No way.
Why did you say help?
You need help. Everybody else is just standing? Okay, cool.
Should I come take my time?
Joy.
I'm so tired.
Wait,
Joy.
Can I take your PC so I can just, like,
wait, Joy. Nice, Skylar.
Catch.
I'm like this, and you're like this.
I wasn't like, ah.
Do we need another reserve pass or no? Okay. Hi. Sorry.
I wasn't asleep actually. I was just like laying.
Sure.
Oh, isn't
I was just laying there. I was just laying there.
Excellent.
Oh,
this one.
I was just thinking with my eyelids. I was because I had one ear open so I could listen to
just
what he was
staring at my eyelids.
I like how you do this.
And,
oh yeah, because you're doing substitution, that's why. So then you took this and you plugged it in there to the other one. Good, 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 good. Interesting way of thinking about that. I like how you think. You pulled out a three from both, which you end up going
to
put back in, but still. Interesting way of thinking about it. Excellent. So 10/3. Then you plugged it into this one. Now, this is fine. The reason I plugged it in here, because I know I'm going to multiply by 3, it's going to get rid of it. That's just a smart, like, next level 40 chess move, right? If you don't see that big brain move, no big deal. You plug it in here. Excellent. Add this. 50 over 3. This right here is going to be 150 over 3. Right? 150 divided by 3 is that, and so when you add 50 over 3, you're going to get 200 over 3. Right? Does that make sense? And then that's 5, and so B equals 40 over 3.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, you did great. That was really good. Have I mentioned how proud of you I am lately? Not this week, because I haven't seen you yet. I'm proud of you.
That's CJ.
What?